Okay, this is Hotel Production Value. Welcome back. I'm Laure, and today we are asking ourselves if the Heisenberg Uncertainty Principle can be explained intuitively. The answer comes to us from an anonymous scientist, and it is the most elegant explanation I have ever seen, so buckle up and enjoy. Heisenberg developed what is now known as the Heisenberg Uncertainty Principle and explained it beautifully with his sentence. The more precisely you know the position of a particle, the less precisely you can simultaneously know the momentum of that same particle. Classical sound waves are the best way to make an analogy and explain this principle. Let's assume we are playing a sound that is just one pure sine wave of a frequency f and amplitude a. This sound has been playing forever, from the beginning of time to the end of time. If we represent it in the frequency amplitude space, we see that we have no amplitude at any frequency except for the frequency f we are playing. The graph looks like a Dirac delta function, zero everywhere except at the exact value of the played frequency. This graph actually shows us the Fourier decomposition of the wave function. A Fourier decomposition is a mathematical method that lets us sum up as many sine functions as we need to reproduce a function down to our desired precision level. Each of these sine functions has its own frequency f, and in this very specific case, we can represent our wave function with just one sine, because we played a sound that is just one sine. Now, let's play this same pure sine wave for a shorter amount of time between t0 and t1. There is no sound before the music and no sound after. As a result, if we need more than one sine function in the Fourier decomposition, we need to reproduce the part with the music as well as the part without music and the transition from one to the next. As the time we play the note gets shorter, we need more and more sine with different frequencies to accurately represent our data. But what happens when we consider the limit where we only play a sound for a brief moment of time? Up until now, we have seen that the shorter the time we play, the more frequency we need to describe the wave function of the sound. And if we consider an infinitely short amount of time, we cannot really play any frequency at all with our sound. There is just no time for anything but a burst of sound. So we need a finite portion of sound to deduce a frequency, and the existence of a frequency at all requires us to measure a certain amount of time. We cannot measure a frequency if the time is too small. We cannot measure a limited time if we only have one frequency. So that's the essence of the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. You cannot know both at the same time because they each depend on the other one. And this concludes the explanation. See, it was short and sweet. I'm glad that you are watching my video. If you learned something, please give this video a like, and if you'd like to know more, I invite you to watch another video on my channel.